Everyone, it's Billy Root from 58magazine.com, and thank you for watching The Art of Dreaming. These films are about the second intention, the power to see the unseen. In order to change the world on the outside, we must change it on the inside. For our consciousness and energy is what creates reality, your life, your purpose, and your destiny. And in this episode, I will talk about mental force. The main difference between successful and unsuccessful people is energy, invincible and determined energy. These two things will sweep away mighty barriers and will conquer the great obstacles. Used together, it is unstoppable. Energy is wasted by many due to distractions and constantly being busy, which turns into a nervous force that accomplishes nothing. Invincible determination is key. If it thrills you, then get to it. Everyone has a giant will, but the majority of us are too lazy to use it. If we can build up our courage to that point and hold it, we will be able to call into play that wonderful power, the human spirit, our divine director, which is unlimited energy and invincible determination.
Do you know, we believe we can do it, Joey. When you and I first saw you, that you'd be the best of us. That's why he bought you. He knows you've all the courage you never had.
And if you can get these words vibrating into your being, you will become a giant among ants. Feel this energy within you, a new life, and your nerves will tingle. Put them into practice in the battle of life, and you will become a rarity in this world that accomplishes. In order to attain a thing, it is necessary that the mind should fall in love with it and be conscious of its existence, almost to the exclusion of everything else. You must get in love with the thing you wish to attain, just as much if you were to meet the woman or man you wish to marry.
Together again, wherever you are, I will find you, and I will bring you home.
You must get in love with the thing you want on the inside, earnestly. None of this flirting, but real love. Men and women in search of success must make that the desired thing, and ruling passion must keep the mind on track. Mental force operates best when it is concentrated. You must give to the desired thing your best and most earnest thought. The mind works on the subconscious plane, remember, and almost always along the lines of the ruling passion or desire. It will fix up things and patch together plans and schemes, and when you need them in the most, it will pop them into your consciousness, and you will feel the like hurrahing, just as you had received some valuable aid from the outside.
3 weeks from now, I will be harvesting my crops. Imagine where you will be, and it will be so.
But if you scatter your thought force, the subconscious mind will not know how to please you, and the result is that you are apt to be put off from the source of aid and assistance.
I'll never be like you!
No, stop that!
I'd rather die than be like you!
Merida, you are a princess, and I expect you to act like one.
Besides this, you will miss the powerful result of concentrated thought and the conscious working out of the details of your plans. When you are ruled by one passion, you bring to draw to yourself persons, things, and results that will aid in the working out of the plan. And you will also place yourself in the current of attraction, where you are brought into contact with those who will be glad to help because of harmonious interests. Do not allow mental leaks and stay focused on the desired outcome.
Maybe there are different ways to be brave. Did you know the French have the best carrier pigeons? And this could be the difference in the war. Our message is getting through.
I don't want to hear about the birds.
They are released at the front and told to go home. This is all they know. But to get there, they must fly over a war. Can you imagine such a thing? Here you are flying over so much pain and terror, and you know you can never look down. You have to look forward, or you'll never get home. I ask you, what could be braver than that?
Keep the desire fresh and active and let it get in its work without interference from conflicting desires. Keep in love with the thing you wish to attain. Feed your fancy with it. See it as accomplished already, but don't lose your interest. Keep your one ruling passion strong and vigorous. One mental love is all that a man and woman needs, one at a time. The love of the flower for the sun causes it to grow away from dark places so that it may receive the light. Desire is a manifestation of this universal life force and of love. Nothing but intense love will enable you to surmount the many obstacles placed in your path. Life is not the result of chance. It is law in full operation, whether you believe it or not.
But you don't have it yet. I'm sorry.
When will I know I'm ready?
You won't. It's a leap of faith. That's all it is, Miles. A leap of faith.
Look at the stars. The great kings of the past look down on us from those stars.
Really?
Yes. So whenever you feel alone, just remember that those kings will always be up there to guide you. And so will I.
But I can't see them, Dad.
Keep looking, son. Keep looking.
You may be ignorant to the law and how it operates, and so it will most likely bring you more trouble. Or you can fall in love with the law and get into the current, and life will transform in front of your eyes. Remember, thoughts are things. It is your mystical power that you cannot see. They go forth from you in all directions, combining thoughts of like kind. Your mind attracts the thoughts of others which have been sent out by them consciously or unconsciously.
Mom? You're a bear! Why a bear? Oh, that scathy witch gave me a gammy spell. It's not my fault. I didn't ask her to change you into a bear. I just wanted her to change you.
But it only attracts thoughts which are in harmony with its own. Like attracts like, and opposites repel opposites in the world of thought. Strong belief is like a strong wish. The successful believes in themselves, and in ultimate success paying no attention to the setbacks, stumble, tumbles, and slips, presses on eagerly to the goal and believing all the time that they will get there.
Your friends are in trouble. You're all alone. Your tech is missing. What are you going to do about it?
I'm going to kick his ass.
They feel it and believe it, and set into operation the strongest forces known in the world of thought. We must auto-suggest and correct ourselves in our mind. A state of discouragement is not the one in which bright ideas come to us. It is only when we are enthused and hopeful that our minds work out the bright ideas which we may turn to account. Don't undervalue yourself or others. You are made of wonderful and powerful things, and locked within your mind are many wonderful things. Make something out of that wonderful stuff.
Do you see him?
I don't see anything.
Look closer. You see? He lives in you.
Simba. You must take your place in the circle of life.
I can't.
You must remember who you are, the one true king.
I'm sorry. I don't know how to be like you.
As king, I was most proud of one thing. Having you as my son.
That was a long time ago.
No, Simba. That is forever.
Please, don't leave me again.
I never left you. I never will. Remember who you are. Remember.
And so, I ask again, who are you?
Believe in yourself, in your own inherent power. Be aware of any mental leaks and auto-correct them in their place. Make every effort count and love yourself enough to have courage. If you set your mind to the tune of courage, confidence, strength, and success, you attract to yourself thoughts of like nature, people of like nature, and things that fit in that mental tune. Get in touch with all the thoughts of that kind that are emanating every hour from hundreds of minds. Get the best that is to be had in the thought world. Get in harmony with law, yourself, and energy. When you arrive, you experience this knowledge firsthand. You know how to use this material while the rest of the crowd does not.
That's a lot of hoopla for such a little horse!
Though he be but little, he is fierce.
What's that?
That's Shakespeare, boys. That's Shakespeare.
Don't waste your good stuff on watchers and critics who are standing around watching you work. Then you will become successful and be paid for your play, which is happiness and joy, the destiny for all of us. Start to work making something worthwhile in the mind. The more you love it, the greater will be the attractive force exerted toward its attainment, both within yourself and outside of you. Love one thing at a time, and that journey begins with you.
I want you back, Mommy. Mom, you're back! You changed.
Oh, darling. We both have.
For watching, and please don't forget to subscribe and check out my workshop, The Art of Dreaming, on 58magazine.com, a platform with content to curate your life. And The Art of Dreaming helps you to find your purpose that you came here to experience and matter, so you can raise your energy, conquer your self-doubt, and become an artist of your life by determination and joyful creativity. creation.